शिव समारंभा शंकराचार्य मध्यमास्मदाचार्य पर्यंता वंदे गुरु परंपरा श्रुतिश्रुतिपुराणनामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतो वंदे भगवन्तो पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदे विभागिने व्योमोद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमो सहनावतु सहनं वक्तु सवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्वीतमस्तमाशावी ब्रह्मणिधातुमेतादृश्य प्रणोति तस्मै तगुम्भदेवमात्मबुद्धि प्रकाशं मुक्षुर्वै शरणं हं प्रपद्ये शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः ॐ नयन्ते संसिद्धमाधिमध्यान्तवर्जितमानन्दमात्मज्योतिरुपास्महे फोर्टीएथ सूत्र इंट्रोडक्शन से पूर्व विद्याभेदे अपि स्तुत्यर्थत्वेन गुणोपसंहारो यथा अभ्यदायी तथा द पूर्वपक्षी सूत्र इन दि आदराधिकरणम दैट कम्स अप इट विल बी रिस्पोंडेड टू बाय दि सिद्धांती इन दि नेक्स्ट सूत्र सो फॉर व्हाट वी हैव सीन इज जस्ट टू सी हाउ द प्रोसेस हैज बीन इन एनालिसिस इन मीमांसा For the Siddhanti, sometimes when there is Vedya Abheda, in Upasana, the Upasya Bheda is there, Vedya Bheda is there, then whenever there is Vedya Bheda, Upasya Devata Bheda, then the Vidya Bheda is seen. Sometimes when the Vedya Abheda is there, meaning Upasya Devata are one and the same across Shakhas or across various mantras, then there can be Vidya Abheda, meaning Upasanas can be one and the same, and Guna Upasamahara has to be done. You have to club together the Upasana as a single Upasana, across mantras, across shakhas, the Upasana should be clubbed together. Sometimes, even if there is a difference in, sometimes when there is no difference in Upasya, there can be a difference in Vidya, Upasanas, but for Adarartha, for Adara, which was seen earlier, as to Kamadi. So here we have seen Na Vayam Upasanartham Upasamharam Bruma. So Upasamhara of gunas across sections should be done when the Vedya is not different. It's one and the same. When the Upasya Devata is one and the same, or the Tatparya is one and the same in Jnana Kanda, then the Guna Upasamhara should be done. There can be difference in Vedya in specific case, such as one is an Upasana and the other one is Neya. One has Upasya, the other has Neya, Brahma. Both are Brahma, but one is Upasya, the other is Neya. Therefore, there has to be a Vidya Bheda. There has to be difference in Upasanas or in Vidya. In Jnana and Upasana, there has to be some difference, because Saguna Upasana is prescribed in one place on the same Brahma, whereas Nirguna Brahma Jnana is revealed regarding the same entity Brahma across sections, across shakhas. But still Guna Upasamhara should be done, because Vedya Abheda is there. The Upasya or the Jnaya is one and the same. Brahma is one and the same. Now the Upasana and Jnana, there has to be difference. Upasana cannot be Jnana, Jnana is not Upasana. Keno Upanishad has said it multiple times, Nedam Idam Upasate. So there has to be a difference. This was the claim made by the Purvapakshi, to which Siddhanti said Badama. We agree, partially we agree. So therefore the answer given as to why Guna Upasamhara should still be done even if there is Vidya Bheda, Upasana and Jnana Bheda, सो न वयम उपासनार्थम उपसंहारम ब्रूमः अपितु विद्या स्तुत्यर्थम फॉर द स्तुति ऑफ विद्या यू हैव टू टेक ऑल द गुणास फ्रॉम सगुण एज वेल एज निर्गुण सेक्शंस. नाउ टेकिंग दैट एज क्यू द पूर्व पक्षी इज मेकिंग एन आरोप पूर्व विद्याभेदे अपि स्तुत्यर्थत्वेन गुणोपसंहार यथा अभ्यदायी एंड ही सेज दैट देयर इज अ विद्याभेद डिफरेंस इन विद्या वन इज उपासना द अदर इज उपासना विद्या द अदर इज ज्ञान विद्या ज्ञानकांड अंतर्गत विद्या बट स्टिल गुणोपसंहार वॉज डन यथा अभ्यदायी इट वॉज established by the Siddhanti for what purpose? Sutyarthatvena. Sutyarthatva was the hetu. Stuti was the hetu due to which Gunaupasamhara was done, is to be done tatha. Similarly now he brings up a context. Of what? Of Pranagnihotra. We have seen this earlier. Bhojana, during Bhojana, the first anna, anna has the meaning here of rice, specifically cooked rice, that is anna. In Kannada, the word anna is used for this cooked rice only. Although in Sanskrit, the anna shabda is generic meaning, anything that is eaten is called anna. Adabhakshani. But still, anna here means rice specifically because in many homas you see the charu, what is called as charu otherwise, that anna, rice, cooked rice is offered in homa. Now bhojana is also homa. We have seen this earlier. So what is offered to Vaishvanara Agni, that ahuti, is called as प्राण आहुति और प्राण अग्निहोत्र. देयर द फर्स्ट राइस कुक्ड राइस इज टू बी ऑफर्ड मीनिंग द फर्स्ट ईटन राइस फर्स्ट शुड बी द राइस विच इज ईटन दैट इज वाई राइस शुड बी द फर्स्ट थिंग टू बी सर्व और इवन इफ इट इज नॉट द फर्स्ट थिंग many other places different things are served and then the rice is served in functions in Vaidika culture, but still before one starts eating rice has to be served and that rice has to be offered prathamam homiyam, that rice which is eaten, the first one is to be offered to prana. So pranaya swaha vyanaya swaha udhanaya swaha ityadi mantras vidhi mantras, the ahuti is given. Now purva pakshi says then this bhojana is being done, that time you eat anna and that anna is offered, but what about on the upavasa day such as ekadashi etc.? On ekadashi anna should not be eaten, rice is not to be eaten. So what about that case when rice is not to be eaten? Then how will you do agnihotra, prana agnihotra? That prana agnihotra lopa will take place. When bhojana lopa takes place, obviously since rice is not being eaten, then how will you offer that as ahuti? You cannot. Therefore there is prana agnihotra lopa also. Purva pakshi says it is not so. So his argument is that even when there is bhojana lopa, still for the stuti of prana agnihotra it has to be done. Prana agnihotra alopa, prana agnihotra should be done, one has to offer. Now what one has to be offer, whether rice, one is not eating rice, how can he offer rice? Should something else be offered? So in that context purva pakshi says prana agnihotra is a nitya agnihotra, you cannot bypass that, and for stuti the prana agnihotra should be done even when there is bhojan lopa, such as in ekadashi etc., on ekadashi day etc. So this is the context for the adharadhikaranam. Tatha, so similarly says the purva pakshi, bhojan lope api, even if there is no bhojana on particular days or for whatever reasons, purva bhojana stutyupapattyartham प्राण अग्निहोत्र अलोपः इति दृष्टांत संगत्य इदमाह। सो द अर्लियर भोजन वेर द प्राण अग्नित्व वाज डन फॉर द स्तुति ऑफ दैट that will become tenable, otherwise the stuti, that what is the stuti, that is agnihotra itself, prana agnihotra is agnihotra itself, that kind of a stuti and more can also be there in the shruti. For that purpose the prana agnihotra alopa, prana agnihotra alopa iti drushtanta sangatya idamaha, this becomes the exemplified from the perspective of the purva pakshi, taking the example from the earlier adhikarana given by the siddhanti. Thereby, आह आदराधिकरणम् आदरादलोपः आदरादलोपः। So पूर्वपक्षी सूत्र is that आदरात् अलोपः, due to आदर अलोप, कस्य अलोप, प्राणाग्निहोत्रस्य अलोप। So in जाबाल श्रुति it is said, what is the आदरा there, how is the आदरा given, another way to look at it is that the Atithi, when Atithi comes, Atithi is the one who comes without Tithi, that is Atithi. So Atithi is to be fed first, this is a general niyama. Whenever a guest comes, generic term translation as guest, but Atithi has a connotation as to one who has not taken appointment and come, he has just arrived, so we consider the Atithi Deo Bhav. So we consider him as, one should consider the Atithi as Bhagwan himself, so he should be treated as Bhagwan, therefore should be fed first. Now even in comparison with that Atithi, the Shruti says that the person who is doing Prana Agnihotra, that person should eat first, he should feed himself even before the Atithi. So Atithev Purvam Prana Agnihotrana Prana Agnihotrinaha Bhojanasya Adarat. So Adara is shown as to this Prana Agnihotra is so important, says the Jabala Shruti, that it the Vaishvanara Agni of the Yajamana should be fed even before the Atithi. So that is the Adara, and since that Adara is there, even before the Atithi if one has to eat, it is superseding the general well known rule, therefore even on Upavasa days he has to do Prana Agni Hotra, says the Purva Pakshi. That is the Sutra Artha. And then what should he eat? Oh, you can eat, you know, with water, with, you know, with milk, etc. Whatever you are taking, that is pratinidhi to bhojana, and that pratinidhi bhojana dvara prana agnihotrasya alopaha. Prana agnihotra should be done even with what you are consuming. Let it not be cooked rice, says the Purva Pakshi. अत्र पूर्वपक्षे प्रतिनिधि न्यायेन प्राणाग्निहोत्र कर्तव्यता आवश्यकत्वम्, प्रतिनिधि न्यायेन. सो ही सेज दैट इफ समवन, इफ द किंग कैन नॉट कम देन किंग सेंड्स हिज प्रतिनिधि. सिमिलरली व्हेन अन्ना कैन नॉट बी ऑफर्ड, प्रतिनिधि कैन बी ऑफर्ड, व्हाट एवर यू आर पार्टेकिंग ऑन एकादशी एटसेट्रा ऑन उपवास डेज यू कैन ऑफर दैट. सो अत्र पूर्वपक्षे प्रतिनिधि न्यायेन, यूजिंग दैट प्रतिनिधि न्याय, प्राण अग्निहोत्र कर्तव्यता आवश्यकत्वम्, दिस कर्तव्यत्वम् इज देयर इन प्राण अग्निहोत्र, देयरफॉर ऑन भोजन लोपा डेज आल्सो इट शुड बी डन आवश्यकत्वम्, प्राण अग्निहोत्र शुड बी डन. सिद्धांति हाउएवर इन द पर्सपेक्टिव ऑफ सिद्धांति व्हाट इज इट, तद अनवतारात् तद अनावश्यकत्वम् इति फलभेदः. Since he is not eating anna on that day, on bhojan lopa he is not eating anna, therefore anavashyakatvam, there is no necessity to offer anything at all. It is not that in homa if rice is not available and charu should be offered. It is not available or somebody made something else that can be offered. It is not true. Whatever the Shruti says, Anna has to be offered as Charu, as Ahuti in the Homa, only that should be offered. You cannot have Pratinidhi Nyaya there. If Anna is not available, you don't pour water or milk, etc., curd, etc., as offering. Iti Phalabheda, this is the difference. Chandogye Vaishwanara Vidyayam Pranagnihotram Shruyate. In Vaishwanara Vidya, that is seen in Chandogya, this Pranagnihotra is heard there, is revealed as to what? Sayam Prathamam Ahutim Juhiyat Tam Juhiyat Pranaya Swaha Ityadina. So Pranaya Swaha, etc., these mantras are given. And it is a Vidhi Juhiyat. So Juhiyat is what? Prathamam Ahutim Juhiyat. Sayam Prathamam Ahutim Juhiyat Tam Juhiyat Pranaya Swaha. So the first Ahuti is to Prana. In Bhojana, what is given to Vaishwanara Agni, the first Anna that is offered is to Prana. Ityadina Tatra Kim Bhojana Lope Prana Agni Uttrasya Lopaha Uta Lopa Iti Sandeh. This is very clear when the doubt comes up as to whether when Bhojana is not being done by the Yajamana, then also should he do Prana Agni Uttra or should he not do? Bhojana Lope Agni Uttrasya Alopaha, says the Purvapakshi. This is a Purvapakshi Sutra. So he says, even when there is no bhojana being done, Anna is not eaten, something else should be offered. Prana Agni Uttra cannot be left because it is Nitya Karma. Kutaha Puro Atithi Bhyo Ashniyat Iti Javala Shrutya Puro Bhojanasya Prathamya Rupa Dharma Lopam Asaha Manaya Prana Agni Hotre Adara Karnat. So Purvapakshi gives the Hetu as to what? Javala Shruti is the Hetu for that, which says Purvaha Ashniyat, Atithi Bhyo Purvaha Ashniyat. Even before the Atithi, the Yajamana should eat who is doing Prana Agnihotra. Iti Javala Shrutya Purva Bhojanasya Prathamya Rupa. So the Purva Bhojanasya Prathamya Rupa Dharma Lopam Asahmanaya Prana Agnihotre Adara Karanat. So the first, not the earlier, I said earlier, Purva is because the Yajamana is eating earlier, therefore the earlier eating, the first eating, that itself becomes the Pramana. So that is the Purva Bhojana. So Purva Bhojana Stuti Upapatyartham. Otherwise the Javala Shruti, the earlier to whom? Earlier to the Atithi. That Bhojana Stuti will not become meaningful. Not the earlier Agnihotra. In the introduction, I made a mistake. I think I said earlier Agnihotra. What it means is earlier Agnihotra, which is Prana Agnihotra, as the Bhojana of the Yajamana, which should be Purva, earlier to whom? Earlier to Atithi. That is the Stuti. So, Purva Bhojana Stuti Upapatyartham. So that this Javala Shruti, which does the Stuti by saying that Agnihotra is so great that even before the Devata, Sakshat Devata who has come in the form of Atithi, Yajamana who is doing Agnihotra, that Yajamana who has Vaishwanara Agni within, he should be fed first, he should be offered first, even before the Devata, Atithi Rupa Devata. So that Stuti is there for this Prana Agnihotra. That will become tenable only when, even when there is Bhojana Lopa, one should do Prana Agnihotra. And that is the Prathamya Rupa Dharma. In the Vritti, it is Prathamya Rupa Dharma Lopam Asamanaya Prana Agnihotre Adhara Karanat. So which Shruti? This Javala Shruti. Through the Javala Shruti. And for that there is Visheshana. What is that? Alopam. Not alopam, prathamya rupa dharma lopam. That is the karma to this Javala Shruti, which is asamana. So for asamana is the visheshana to Javala Shruti, and in tritiya it will become asamanaya. Kim asamanaya? What does it not tolerate? Literally does not tolerate. అసమాన. సో జాబాల శృతి ఓంట్ టాలరేట్ దిస్. వాట్ ఇట్ విల్ నాట్ టాలరేట్? ప్రాథమ్య రూప ధర్మ లోప. దిస్ ప్రాథమ్య ఫస్ట్ హోమీయ ఆహుతి, దట్ ఈస్ ది ధర్మ, అండ్ దట్ ధర్మ లోప ఇట్ ఓంట్ టాలరేట్. విచ్ ఇస్ దట్ ధర్మ? ప్రథమ ఆహుతి ఈజ్ ది ప్రాథమ్య రూప ధర్మ. ప్రథమ ఆహుతి, దట్ ఇస్ వై ఇట్ ఇస్ మార్క్డ్. ఐ వాజ్ మెన్షనింగ్ ది ఎర్లియర్ పాఠ. ఐ వాజ్ ట్రైంగ్ టు కనెక్ట్ దీస్ ఇన్ ది వృత్తి సో దట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఈజీ టు సీ యాజ్ టు ఛాందోగ్య ఆల్సో టాక్స్ అబౌట్ ప్రథమ ఆహుతి. ప్రాథమ్య రూప ధర్మ ఈజ్ డిస్కస్ ఇన్ జాబాల శృతి, అండ్ దాట్ కెనాట్ బి డిస్కౌంటెడ్. ఇట్ విల్ బి మీనింగ్ఫుల్ ఓన్లీ వెన్ ప్రాణాగ్నిహోత్ర ఈజ్ డన్ ఈవెన్ ఆన్ భోజన లోప. దేర్ఫోర్ ప్రాణాగ్నిహోత్రే ఆదరకరణ, దిస్ ఇస్ హేతు. ఆదరాద్ ఈజ్ హేతు, మీనింగ్ ఆదరకరణాత్. సిన్స్ ది స్తుతి విత్ రిస్పెక్ట్ హ్యాస్ బీన్ డన్ బై జాబాల శృతి, దేర్ ఫోర్ వన్ షుడ్ ఫాలో దిస్ ప్రాణాగ్నిహోత్ర. నహి ధర్మలోప సహమాన, నహి ధర్మలోపం అసహమాన శృతి ధర్మిణ ప్రాణాగ్నిహోత్రస్య లోపం సహతే. సో వాట్ ఈస్, హౌ ఇస్ ద హేతు వర్కింగ్? సో ది పూర్వపక్షి సేస్ దట్ దిస్ ధర్మలోప, ఇట్ ఈస్ అ ధర్మ. ప్రాణాగ్నిహోత్ర ఈజ్ అ ప్రాథమ్య రూప ధర్మ. ఈటింగ్ ఫస్ట్ అండ్ ఈవెన్ బిఫోర్ ది అతిథి, దాట్ ఈస్ అ ధర్మ ఫర్ దిస్ యజమాన. సో దాట్ శృతి, జాబాల శృతి, విచ్ డస్ నాట్ అగ్రీ విత్ ది ధర్మలోప, సచ్ ధర్మలోప, దాట్ శృతి ధర్మిణ ప్రాణాగ్నిహోత్రస్య లోపం న సహతే. వేర్ దిస్ ధర్మ కెనాట్ బి గివెన్ అప్ యాజ్ పర్ ది శృతి, దాట్ శృతి కెనాట్ అగ్రీ విత్ వాట్ లోప్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాణాగ్నిహోత్ర. ప్రథమ ఆహుతి ఈజ్ అ ధర్మ, అండ్ ప్రథమ ఆహుతి ఈజ్ ఆహుతి ఈజ్ పాసిబుల్ ఓన్లీ ఇన్ ప్రాణాగ్నిహోత్ర. దేర్ ఫోర్ ప్రాణాగ్నిహోత్ర కెనాట్ నాట్ బి దేర్, ఇట్ హ్యాస్ టు బి డన్, ఇట్ ఈస్ నిత్య. అదర్వైజ్ ప్రాథమ్య రూప ధర్మ విల్ నాట్ బి ఫాలోడ్. అతః అలోప ఇది పూర్వపక్ష. దేర్ ఫోర్ పూర్వపక్షి హ్యాస్ కన్క్లూడెడ్ దట్ నిత్య అగ్నిహోత్ర, దిస్ ప్రాణ అగ్నిహోత్ర ఇస్ అ నిత్య అగ్నిహోత్ర, ఇట్ హ్యాస్ టు బి డన్ ఈవెన్ ఆన్ భోజన లోప. సిద్ధాంతస్తు, సిద్ధాంతి డిసగ్రీస్, అండ్ భగవాన్ సూత్రకార సేస్ దట్ ఉపస్థితే తద్వచనాత్, ఉపస్థితే తస్తద్వచనాత్. సో ఉపస్థితే అతః తద్వచనాత్, ఉపస్థితే, ఉపస్థితే మీన్స్ వాట్? ఓన్లీ వెన్ ఉపస్థితే భోజనే, భోజనే ఉపస్థితే సతి ఏవ, ఓన్లీ వెన్ భోజన ఈజ్ బీయింగ్ డన్, నాట్ ఆన్ భోజన లోప డేస్, ఓన్లీ వెన్ భోజన ఈజ్ డన్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు ఆఫర్ అగ్నిహోత్ర, షుడ్ బి డన్ ప్రాణాగ్నిహోత్ర. అతః దేర్ ఫోర్ వాట్? అతః 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 ఈజ్ యర్ అస్మాత్, ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ అస్మాత్ తద్వచనా, తద్వచనాత్ ఈజ్ దిస్ వచన హ్యాస్ బీన్ గివెన్ ఇన్ పూర్వమీమాంస. సో ఇన్ పూర్వమీమాంస తద్యత్ భక్తం ప్రథమం ఆగచ్చే తద్ హోమీయం. సో దేర్ ఇస్ దిస్ వచన నాట్ ఇన్ సారీ నాట్ ఇన్ పూర్వమీమాంస, ఇన్ ఛాందోగ్య, ఇన్ ఛాందోగ్య ఇట్ సెల్ఫ్ వేర్ ఇట్ హ్యాస్ బీన్ సెడ్ స యాం ప్రథమాం ఆహుతిం జుహ్యాత్, దట్ ఈస్ ది 519.1 దట్ మంత్ర. ఇన్ దట్ మంత్ర ఇట్ సెల్ఫ్ ద అదర్ పార్ట్ సేస్ వాట్? తద్యత్ భక్తం ప్రథమం ఆగచ్చేత్ తద్ హోమీయం, ప్రథమం ఆగచ్చేత్ చేదేవ్, దాట్ విచ్ హ్యాస్ బీన్ కుక్డ్ అండ్ సర్వ్డ్ ఓన్లీ దాట్ హ్యాస్ టు బి ఆఫర్డ్. ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ కుక్డ్ హౌ కెన్ యూ ఆఫర్ సంథింగ్ ఎల్స్? యూ కెనాట్. సో దాట్ బికమ్స్ హేతు, దట్ ఈస్ తద్వచనాత్ హేతు. సో ఈ జంప్డ్ అహెడ్ ఇన్ ది వృత్తి టు సీ ది హేతు దేర్. సో ఉపస్థితే, ఓన్లీ వెన్ భోజన ఇజ్ ఉపస్థిత, దెన్ అలోన్ అతః తద్వచనాత్. అస్మాద్ హోమం, దిస్ హోమం హ్యాస్ టు బి డన్ ఓన్లీ, దిస్ హోమ హ్యాస్ టు బి డన్ ఓన్లీ వెన్ ది హోమీయ అన్న ఈజ్ కుక్డ్ ఉపస్థితే, అండ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ కుక్డ్ అండ్ ఈజ్ ఈటన్, నాట్ ఓన్లీ కుక్డ్, ఇట్ మే బి కుక్ ఫర్ అదర్స్ హు ఆర్ నాట్ డూయింగ్ ఉపవాస ఇత్యాది, బట్ యజమాన్ ఇఫ్ ఈజ్ డూయింగ్ ఉపవాస దెన్ ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ ప్రథమం హోమీయం అన్నం ఫర్ హిమ్ అట్ ఆల్. Therefore, if it is not homium annam, even if it is cooked for others, it cannot be offered. Then can he offer something else? No, there is no such niyama. He cannot just offer anything and everything to the Vaishvanara Agni, to Prana. That is the Sutra Artha. Just let me look up if I missed something there. I just want to cross check that Ataha once more. Because Hetu is there, but Ataha. It is in Samana Adhikaran with Upasthite. So, Upasthite Bhojane. So, Asmadeva Bhojana Dravyat. Yeah, it is there here itself. So, Bhojana Dravyat. From that, so Panchami here, this Ataha is Panchami, but not Hetau Panchami. It is from that source. So, it is Karaka Panchami. As to from that very source which is cooked, which is that Anna. Upasthite Eva. So, Bhojane Upasthite. Bhojanat Dravyat Homiyam Annam should be offered. Juyat. But this Homiyam Annam is not there at all because he is not having Upasthiti of this Anna at all. This Yajamana who is doing Pranagnyutra. Therefore, what? Tadvachanat. That Tadvachanat becomes the Hetu. Since the Shruti says that only if it is a Homiya Prathama. Homiya Anna, only that should be offered. It is not Prathama Homiya Anna for the Yajamana since there is Bhojana Lopa for him. Therefore, it is not to be offered. Nothing else can be offered either. So, Bhojane cha upasthite Ataha Asmadeva Bhojana Dravyat Prana Agnihotram Kartavyam. So, Siddhanti is disagreeing and says that only when there is upasthiti of Bhojana, when the Yajamana is having Bhojana Anna, Ataha, from that Anna, Asmadeva Bhojana Dravyat Annat, Prana Agniotram Kartavyam, the Prana Agniotra should be done. Anupasthiti, however, on Bhojana Lopa, there is Anupasthiti of, there is no Anna present for this Yajamana, therefore, Anupasthiti to Agnihotra se Lopaeva, Agnihotra won't be there, Prana Agniotra is not to be done on that day. Kutaha tadvachanat. Why? The hetu is such a thing has been mentioned in the same Shruti Chandogya. Tadyad bhaktam prathamam agachhe tad homiyam iti vachanat. So you have to club together the Chandogya vachana when you are reading Jabala Shruti also. So Purvapakshi is saying, Jabala Shruti is saying that even before the Atithi he should eat. Okay, let him eat. But then it does not mean that he should be doing Agnihotra on that day because there is Bhojana Lopa. He does not have Dravya to offer at all. Iti Vachanat. Due to this statement in Chandogya. Adara Vachanam tu. But what about the Jabala Shruti? Asked the Puro Pakshi to him. Siddhanti answers Adara Vachanam tu. Bhojana Prasakti Deshayam Drashtavyam. So Bhojana Prasakti Deshayam Eva Drashtavyam. This Deshayam does not seem right. It should be Dashayam, not Deshayam. I read Dashayam, but then I saw this. So Dashayam, it should be Dashayam. Sorry. Let me mark this. So only when there is Bhojana being done, Bhojana Prasakti, only when Bhojana is being done by this Yajamana, then that time he has to offer, eat before the Atithi also, that Vachana is valid only in that case. Adar Vachanam tu Bhojana Prasakti Dashayam Drashtavyam. Only in that Dasha, only in that situation when he has Bhojana Prasakti, Yajamana is eating Anna. That time he has to do Prana Agnihotra. That is the Adar Vachana in Jabala Shruti also. It is applicable only when there is Bhojana Alopa. That adhikarana is over. The next tannirdharana adhikarana comes up with an introduction in the vritti as Purvam anitya bhojana ashrita pranagni hotrasya anityattvam yatha tadvat. So similar to this prana agnihotra which is anitya. Why is it anitya? Because it has ashraya, it is ashrita on anitya bhojana. Bhojana is not nitya. On upavasa days there is no bhojana. On shivratri ityadi days there is no bhojana. So you cannot do prana agnihotra then. So prana agnihotra is anitya because it has dependency on anitya bhojana. So when bhojana is done, prana agnihotra has to be done. When it is not there, prana agnihotra is also not there. Purvam. This is what has been discussed in the earlier adhikrana. Similarly, tadvat nitya karmaanga ashrita upasananam nityatvam iti drishtanta sangatte idamah. So this is an example, but using the reverse logic as to, since there is dependency of agnihotra on bhojana, bhojana becoming anitya, prana agnihotra is also anitya. Now upasana, which is karmanga, dependent on karmanga, ashrita on karma rather. So nitya karma anga ashrita upasana. Now anga means it is ashrita itself. Upasana, which is a part of karma and therefore it has dependency on karma. If that karma is nitya, then upasana will also become nitya, says the Purva Pakshi. He says, I am using similar logic. If bhojana is anitya, then the dependent prana agnihotra becomes anitya. Therefore, based on what is nitya, the dependent should be nitya. Here karma is nitya, then how can the karma anga upasana be anitya? It has to be nitya. So therefore, upasana will also have to be nitya, which are karmanga to the nitya karma. Iti drishtanta sangatya idamaha. There by the next adhikarana, tan nirdharana adhikaranam. Bhagavan Sutrakara says, tan nirdharana niyamas tad drishtev pruthag gyapratibandhav phalam. Here there is a truti. I don't think I have corrected this. There is no dhakara, it is ghakara, okay? So here it is right. This seems to be dha here. There is a typo here. It should be gha. So there is a font issue. So it appears like gha, but it is typed as dha. Some mistake seems to be there. So it has to be corrected. It is ghakara, not dhakara. So again, tan nirdharana niyamas tad drishtev pruthag gyapratibandhav phalam. Tan nirdharana niyamas tad drishtev pruthag gyapratibandhav phalam. So tan nirdharana niyamah. So tan nirdharana aniyamah. This is a single word. Tan nirdharana niyamah tad drishtehe pruthak gyapratibandha phalam. That is a padachheda. What does it mean? The tan nirdhat is tan nirdharani shashti samasa. Tesham kesham, tat stands for karmanga ashrita upasana. So tan nirdharana aniyamah. The tan nirdharana tesham stands for upasananam. Tesham upasananam, which upasana, which are karmanga ashrita. So tesham karmanga ashritanam upasananam nirdharananam aniyamah. Aniyama is nityavat anushthana abhava. Aniyama means there is no nityatvam. Upasanas are not nitya even if they are karmanga ashrita, nitya karmanga ashrita. Sorry, there is no nityatva anushthana needed for upasanas. Upasanas can be done with the karma and karma can be done without upasanas also. Of course, if you do upasanas, karmanga upasanas of the karma, with the karmas if you do upasanas, then you will get more phala. But it does not mean that upasanas have to be done. For example, you are doing some smartha karma also, some chanting, etc. Their dhyana, mantras are there, their upasana is prescribed there. But how many are actually doing upasana when dhyana mantra is chanted? very few really do dhyana. So dhyana is not mandatory, but it is superior if along with sahasranama, if you do dhyana proper. Dhyana mantra chanting is one thing, dhyana shloka chanting is one thing. Doing the dhyana as per specifically as the dhyana shloka says, that's a different thing altogether. One will get phala of the sahasranama even without the dhyana being chanted or actual dhyana being done. So chanting will also give phala. With upasana it will give more phala. With dhyana being done properly, it will give more phala. But it does not mean that the vachika karma of sahasranama won't give phala. It will give phala. Similarly, karma, nitya karma will give phala. It will give more phala if the karmanga upasana, nitya karmanga upasanas are done. But that doesn't mean that the karmanga ashrita upasanas are also nitya. It doesn't mean so, says the Siddhanti. So, atra purva pakshe upasana naam, tan nirdharana aniyamaha, this is the purva pakshis being answered by the Siddhanti. There is no such niyama. Why so? Tadrishtehe, that is a hetu. Tadrishtehe. It is seen so. This aniyama is seen. Tad is aniyama. Tadrishtehe is aniyama drishtehe. The aniyama meaning anityatva of upasana is seen. Where it is seen, we'll see in the vritti. Prathak gyapratibandha phalam. So what is Gyapratibandha? In Padachheda I left that Gyapratibandha is he apratibandha. With this Gakara, Prathak Gakara has become Gakara and Hakara has become Ghakara. So it is he apratibandha. Prathak he apratibandha phalam. So apratibandha is phala. So karma phalat anya apratibandha phalam. There is no pratibandha to the phala to take place. So, this anya phala is there. Karma phalat anya ha, he apratibandha. For phala to occur, there is no pratibandha. Meaning, karma will still give phala, even if upasana is not done. So, apratibandha phalam. We'll see more details, more meaning in the vritti. Since it's a long sutra, we'll have to see so many things and it will be repeated. So, basic meaning you can hold on here as to what? That is the upasanas which are karmanga ashrita. So karmanga ashrita upasanas, and what kind of karma? They are dependent on the nitya karma. So nitya karma anga ashrita upasanas have no such niyama of being nitya. Therefore, that kind of a statement being seen as to aniyama tadrishte, therefore what? You have to understand that there is separate phala of the karma and the upasana sahita karma. Prathak, there is separate phala. This is the hetu. Yasmat karanat prathak karma phalat prathak anyaha upasanasya phalam or upasana sahita karma phalasya phalam apratibandha. There is no such difficulty in getting phala. Apratibandha. Vritti says, Atra Purvapakshe Upasananam Kratushu Parnatadivad Avashyakatvam. Siddhante Godohana Vad Anavashyakatvam Iti Phalabheda. So Purvapakshi says that there is an example that I'll give. Based on that, I am bringing Nityatva to the Upasanas, which are Nitya Karmanga Ashrita. Siddhanti gives another example and he says, no, upasanas are not like that, upasanas are like this example. So the example by the Purvapakshi is Kratushu. In the Kratus, as per the Purvapakshi, upasanas are avashya, avashya kartavya. Why? He says they are like parnatadivat, like parnata. So what is that parnatadivat? This parna, we have seen a little in Arthasangra. So Purva Mimamsaka analyzes as to this palasha kashta should be used for juhu, for juhu to be made for the you know, the vessel which is used to offer ahuti, ghee ityadi, the that ladle kind of a thing, what should it be made of, which wood. So palasha vruksha kashta should be used, that palasha wood should be used. Now this rule, this vidhi comes up in a section which is not connected with anything, meaning it is not connected with a particular karma, and that shruti is called as anarabhya shruti. So parnatadivat is anarabhya shruti, and that anarabhya shruti kim vadati sa shruti, it says that palasha kashta jhum nirmana should be done nirmuniyat. So the nirmana of the production of the juhu should be made with palasha kashta. Now in which karma is it applicable? Because it is anarabhya, anarabhyatvena shruti hi sarvatra yajna patra esha niyama. So this shruti niyama sarvatra, this yajna patra, this juhu which is used as yajna patra, wherever this yajna patra is used, all those places the shruti is applicable, being anarabhya. And similarly, this upasana which is nitya karma anga, says the Purva Pakshi, it is similar, it is like this anarabhya shruti. So upasana has to be done nityatvena. Siddhanti says no, it is not like this parnata shruti, it is like godohana shruti. And what does the godohana shruti say? Godohana shruti says that pashukamaha should do should use this godohana patra as the jala patra. So when the karma is being done where the jala has to be used in a patra, which patra should he use? Where he has in their milk is also being used as dravya in the homa. So in that karma, as jalapatra, if the yajamana uses the same godohana patra, the patra in which the milk has been milked from the cow, the vessel which is used to milk the cow, the same vessel he uses as a jalapatra, then he'll get more phala. What is the phala? Pashulabha is the phala. So one who is pashukama, one who wants more pashu, more cattle is one kind of dhana. So one who wants more cattle, more dhana, he should do what? He should use jalapatra, the godohana patra as jalapatra. So his jalapatra should be the same as godohana patra. The karma is same. Whichever jalapatra you use, whether you use a separate patra or the same godohana patra, the karma is the same. It has to be done in the same manner. Phala will also accrue. But additional pashulabha will be there to one who is using the godohana patra as jalapatra. So it is optional. There is no nityatva in jalapatra being the same godohana patra. Similar is the case of this upasana, which is nitya karma anga ashrita, all right, but itself is not nitya, says the Siddhanti. So with this now we can speed through. Tatra santi karmanga udgita vyapashrayani pranadi upasanani. So pranadi upasanas are there which are anga bhuta, ashrita on what? Vyapashrita on this udgita. Just give me a moment, there is an alarm ringing. So the Siddhanti says that Purva Pakshi and Siddhanti differ here as to the Udgita Ashrita Pranadi Upasana which are there. Kim Tesham Nityavad Anushthanam Uta Neti Sande Nityavad Anushthanam Iti Purva Paksha. Whether these Upasanas which are Pranadi Upasanas which are to be done dependent on the karma while that karma is being done, which is that udgita. Dependent on the udgita, which are anga to karma. Udgita is anga to karma, and there is a dependency of this pranadi upasana on udgita. So anga ashrita, anga is also ashrita, but upasana is ashrita on this anga udgita, which is anga to karma. So this is one way to look at it, or you can look at the anga and ashrita as same also. But the idea is upasana is dependent on something. That something is nitya. Should the upasana be nitya? Purva Pakshi says yes, nitya vadanushtanam, it should be done. Upasanas are nitya. Siddhantastu tesham karmanga ashritanam nirdharananam upasananam aniyamaha nityavad anushtana abhava. We have seen this in the Mula itself. So what is being said is that karmanga ashrita nirdharana aniyama is there. There is nothing to conclude that they are mandatory. So nityavad anushtana abhava, there is no such rule at all which says that these are nitya. Therefore nitya anushtana is not there for upasanas, even if they are dependent on anga, which is for a karma which is nitya. Kutaha, what is hetu tadrushte? This is seen, this aniyama is seen in the shruti, where tasya aniyamasya teno bhav kuruto yaschaita devam veda yascha na veda iti shrutau darshana. So veda yascha veda yascha na veda, both are given in chandogya. So tena ubhav kuruta, both are possible. One can do with upasana, one can do without upasana. So this vidya veda, vidhatu shows upasana there. So yascha etad evam veda, in this manner one who knows or does dhyana, does upasana and then does the karma, or yascha na veda, one who does not know this and still does it. So therefore upasana may or may not be there. Iti shrutau darshana, there is aniyamaha, meaning there is optionality. One can do with this upasana, without the upasana also. Upasana nam pratak phala shravanadapi na nityavad anushtanam ityaha pratak ghyap pratipanda phalam. The ghi is by sandhi he, so he is yasmat. Since what? Pruthak phala shravanadapi upasanana. Upasanas have separate phala also. Additional phala or separate phala. Therefore also api na nitya danushtanam. Therefore also they are not nitya. If you want additional phala, you do it. Like what? Godahana. Godahana use as jalapatra is only for a yajamana who wants pashu. Additional dhanalabha, he should do it. There is no such niyama. Similarly here, he asmat karma phalata pruthak eva apratibandha. Apratibandha phalam. There is no pratibandha to a phala which can come separately with upasanas. Therefore, karma can stand independently and upasanas can have independent, not independent, but have optionality to get more phala. One may or may not do, depending on whether one wants phala or not. One may do additional upasanas. Yadeva vidya karoti shraddhya upanishada tadeva viryavattaram bhavati iti viryavattaratva atma karma samruddhi rupam phalan labhyate. And there is a generic statement also. If Purvapakshi says we are showing one chandogya upanishad antargata statement, what does it have to do with the karma which I am showing? Karma kanda has many other upasanas also. Okay, let it be. Siddhanti says there is a statement which is generic also. In Chandogya there is a generic statement also. And it is in upasana kanda, not in jnana kanda only. So it is in the first chapter itself. Just like the earlier also, it is also first chapter. Yadeva vidya karoti, one who does something with knowledge, that yat, that which is done with knowledge. Vidya karoti shraddhaya upanishada, knowing it very very well. Shraddhaya, with shraddha, and upanishada, using this vidya which is revealed in the shastra. Tadeva viryavattaram bhavati. So tad eva viryavattaram bhavati. Tara pratyaya has been used, meaning that becomes viryavattara, becomes more virya. It does not mean that there is no phala at all. There is a virya phala सक्सेसफुल रिजल्ट इज देयर इवन विदाउट उपासना, विदाउट द उपनिषद उपासना, विदाउट द श्रद्धा ऑल्सो वन डज, स्टिल वन विल गेट. वाई? बिकॉज विथ श्रद्धा वन गेट्स मोर फल. डज नॉट मीन वन विल नॉट गेट फल. वन डज विदाउट श्रद्धा ऑल्सो वन विल गेट सम फल. इट मे नॉट बी ग्रेट बट इट विल बी सम रिजल्ट. देन विथ श्रद्धा मोर रिजल्ट, विथ उपासना स्टिल मोर रिजल्ट. सो विथ विद्या, नोइंग वॉट वन इज डूइंग, मोर रिजल्ट. सो देर आर ग्रेडेशन इन कर्म ऑल्सो बेस्ड ऑन वॉट ऑल इज डन, विथ वॉट एटीट्यूड इट इज डन. सो ऑल दिस विल मैटर. देर फोर देर विल बी मोर एंड मोर सुपीरियर रिजल्ट टू दी अर्लियर लैकिंग वन आर दी अदर, वन आर मोर. इति वीर्यवत्तरत्व आत्मकर्म समृद्धि रूपम फलम लभ्यते. सो समृद्धि, वॉट इज द फल? दैट इज इन दी रूप फॉर्म ऑफ समृद्धि, मोर ग्रोथ. सो कर्म बिकम सुपीरियर एंड दैट इज द स्वरूप ऑफ वीर्यवत्तरत्व, मीनिंग फल सुपीरियरिटी इज देर, फल लभ्यते. अतः न कर्मांगत्वम उपासनानाम इति सिद्धम. देयर फोर उपासनाज आर नॉट अंगा टू दी कर्म एज मैंडेटरी. दे आर अंगा ऑल राइट वेन वन डज इट, बट विदाउट दैट ऑल्सो देर इज अ रिजल्ट. देर फोर देर इज नो अंगा अंगी भाव फॉर वन हु इज टेकिंग द ऑप्शन आउट. ही इज नॉट डूइंग उपासनाज. देर इट इज इट डज नॉट हैव अंगा अंगी भाव एट ऑल. वन हु इज डूइंग उपासनाज, दैट बिकम्स अंगा टू द कर्म. वॉट डज इट मीन इज दैट उपासना कैनॉट बी डन इंडिपेंडेंटली. उपासना हैज टू बी डन विद द कर्म. Karma can be done independently with or without upasanas. Upasanas don't have, karmanga upasanas don't have independent existence. That's what it means by one, there is an angangi bhava only to one who is doing it. For other, there is no angangi bhava, meaning karma has to be done, but upasana need not be done. So this is the vritti we look at more in the next partha. Already late for the following partha. आम्रायन्त संसिद्धमादि मध्यांत वर्जितम आनंद घनम अपूर्णम आत्मज्योतिरूपास्मेह. नमस्ते, धन्यवाद.
धन्यवाद. नमस्कार.